Hello everybody, welcome back to Pixel Kitsune Plays Final Fantasy II. When last we left our intrepid heroes, they were sleeping in a cave, getting ready to go fight a horrible monster with 8 tentacles.
Those damn Japanese.
Again, Kazu is with us, and we'll see where the adventure takes us next. An ice rod! Now we can get rid of that stupid bow.
That lasted long.
Yeah, pretty much. It's there to give her something to use for a tiny, tiny bit of the game.
She killed one whole monster with it.
It was a very important monster to kill.
Hello, Egg Yolks. I remember you.
And now that we've rested, and Rydia has her magic back, she too can electrocute everything in sight.
What is she doing?
Casting a spell. Or playing a Game Boy.
Is she, like, twiddling her thumbs? She's like, me.
We have limitations on animation, but yeah, it's technically her casting animation.
He's probably over in the corner going, I don't know what I'm doing. I hope the spell hits the monsters and not my friends.
There.
Hey, why are you her now?
She can get out of the bag. Because you can switch through all of them.
Oh.
If for some reason you actually like someone's imagery better than someone else's, you can...
That is totally not how she looks from the front, side, whatever. I gave her duo Maxwell's haircut, and then from the front, she looks normal.
Well, I guess it's just kind of a matter of limitations. This is their first attempt at a 16-bit game. They weren't quite sure how far they could push the graphics. When we get around to playing either the sequel to this or to Final Fantasy VI, you will see how far they were able to stretch the Super Nintendo graphics.
See? Look at that. Giant bang of doom.
Finally, we'll be the old man. Old man.
Old man.
With the big bushy beard.
Old man. Going to take out those zombies.
Basically, the rods do the spell, sort of, in a weakened version, but they don't cost any mana points, so it's kind of a way to switch your magic.
Save all your asses.
Yeah, pretty much. Rydia does not know how to learn fire and does not learn it for quite a while.
Oh, yeah, old man.
Because of you. It's weird, you know, you burn down someone's village and they have a phobia about fire.
The heck is this?
This is a secret passage. This is another lovely change from Japan to here. Japan felt that we would not be smart enough to go, I wonder if there's something interesting in that little cave. So.
These look like the same paths from Undertale.
Pretty much. Undertale is kind of based on this type of game, among other things.
Oh,
we can strike first. I love when we strike first, Tella gets lazy. Either that, or she's just leveling fast enough that she's overtaking him stat-wise.
Old man, kick all zombie asses.
Yep. Pretty much the only thing you have against the zombies.
Da, 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 da. You gotta live his Wolverine haircut.
How do you know he's not Wolverine?
Old man Logan.
And hey, we're getting out of here, because these things are immune to damage.
Dear God.
You don't like the jellies?
They look weird. Like they're judging you.
Yeah, they're pretty much vulnerable to magic only. Which makes it kind of obnoxious to deal with them in a normal way. What's his magic at? Huh, he's still fine. I still haven't quite figured out the purpose of this cave. Because on the one hand, it's a way to level up Rydia, but you could just have given her levels.
Just adjust.
But they're essentially giving you someone way above your level that can just go forever with a ton of magic. And I'm not complaining, it makes this stage kind of easy, but it's just kind of this weird thing. And now we are way up in the air for no particular reason. Yay!
Then you don't have any height phobias.
Oh my god, we're high up? Ah! More cave toads. Beware of the cave toads, or they will sit there.
Bonk.
I guess when they were dangerous at one point. Then again, I could also be remembering, again, the Japanese version or the remakes later on when they use the Japanese hard-type version. Essentially, every monster gets an attack for your attack. And by your attack, I mean each character. So Cecil gets to go, and all the monsters get to go. And then Rydia gets to go, and then all the monsters get to go.
Kind of spam you with treasure chests.
On and off, yeah. Money was scarce in the original version of the game, and in this one we have heals, which get rid of all status ailments. Look, we got a new sword for Cecil. Instead of the Shadow Sword, we now have the Darkness Sword. Ooh.
Well, that completely nicks the fact that there you are like, we want you because of the sword you have.
Yeah, we got rid of that sword.
Ooh, it's yellow now.
Yep, Yellow Blade does a lot more damage.
I'm helping! Look, I helped! I cooled them off.
You lit them on fire, and then we...
I'll help you, little fishies! Old man's killing them all! Oh, God! Such violence!
Yeah, you can see a marked difference there from when you get the sword up.
I'll cool you off, eggs! I helped!
Old man, whack.
Hit them with my stick. Yeah, instead of heals that just took care of everything you could possibly get, you pretty much had, there was one type of item for every single status element. So you had to carry antidotes for poison, and mallets for mini, and eye drops for if you got darkness on you, and so on and so forth. And they're expensive, so they try to give you a lot of different items. Except prior to this is before you could switch around turns, so... Oh, it's her turn! So now you have to make her turn. Hey, she likes her invisible Game Boy. Who are you to judge?
I helped! I killed one!
Should you go, it's done, Whippersnapper.
Party, kid. And Cecil's like, can't you people kill eggs? Apparently you can.
I'll kill the magic egg, Cecil. Just watch. I'm useful. Go, egg power. See you helps.
You know what? I was like, oh, I'm just going to hide in embarrassment behind my cape.
Look, at this point, I know you guys are going to run away, so just trying to kill the one before it retreats. Hasn't run away yet. I'm impressed. Oh, there he goes. What I'm really curious about is what the change was here, because last round he was doing like 120 damage to everything. And now he's doing like 70.
You were doing it to the fish, not the eggs.
I don't know. Cecil was killing them at the end, pretty much. Oh, that's where I came from.
Yep.
Look, now we have extra versions of frogs.
We have mad toads. They're angry that you've been killing their kind.
You've been killing our women.
And now we'll kill you! It's really heroes! And what do heroes do? They kill everything. Loot the corpses.
You get those XP points.
Nothing stand in their way. Undertale taught me well.
Execution points.
We can go out from here. The monster's in the cave beyond there. We should camp to regain our strength out there. In our paper tents.
First, we'll be attacked by weird things.
Creepy fishmen.
The Loch Ness Monster. and its friend, Centipede Man.
And now we will continue our epic journey against random flora and fauna.
Aren't you gonna camp?
Yep. And you camp right now. Have our epic tent of paper. Lasts for one night, then destroys itself.
Super cheese tent.
Give us full access to all of our abilities. And now,
it's down here.
We are going to.
This seemed like a brilliant idea at the time.
The thing to consider about this is a trade path. This is how people are supposed to get from one village to the other. Before the monsters start appearing all over the place.
Oh, next Diesel, it's an alligator. We should pet him.
Aha. Alligator is also, it's kind of just a reptiles and amphibians thing in general, are vulnerable to cold versus lightning or anything else under the sun. Hey, Rhea, gained more levels!
Hey, it's helpful!
She got a symbiote!
Yay!
And now she becomes Spider-Man.
Spider!
And now, if I recall right, we're going to find the rest of Cecil's new upgraded gear, because at no point do they ever sell his stuff in cities the way they do for everyone else. And a weird little twist of extraness, they never provide a shield in the middle ground. Because you have the shadow, the darkness, and then eventually just the black armor.
Darkness and pain. Why didn't that change? It should change.
Before they had the graphics for that.
Me.
Nope. Cecil only has one armor change, and that's quite a ways from now.
Brains.
We're gonna go ahead and leave.
But we want your brains.
Basically, because we're almost to the boss fight and we kind of like to conserve magic. And there's Cecil's armor. And he's stuck with that shadow shield for until he can replace it. And we'll go ahead and use one of our cure potions to make sure Rydia is at full health. And now, on to the epic battle against the evil monster!
That thing in the water?
Yep. But first, run away from a crocodile. Alligator, sorry.
Alligator.
Forward to battle.
Look, Mr. Cecil! Tentacles!
He's coming. Holy shit.
Octoman.
Not to be confused with Octodad.
Mr. Cecil, it touched me! It's touching me! Why me?
Yeah, wow, there's hammering on her. Oh yeah, she'll use her ultimate attack that I've held back till now.
The tentacle?
Assuming she doesn't die. Go ahead and get care of her. Nope, not the tentacles. Her true calling.
Yeah, I have no words.
That is her only summon for a long, long while. Why are you obsessed with fighting her? Jesus.
Small. Girl. Tentacles.
Yeah, but she's in the back row, and the game's supposed to, like, prioritize not hitting them as much.
Japan.
Let's see. We're cutting off its legs.
Chicka-ba!
Go, giant bird.
Old man, show you the way.
Should be four left, I believe.
That's five.
No, yep. Behold my elite math skills. I can count. I just want to know what the original people playing this game thought of. Because at this point in time, we all know, like, you know, the full scale of summoning magic and what's going to come and what she'll eventually have to learn. But the first time you're playing this, you never heard of a summoner before. And you're like, oh, she has call. Her mom had a dragon. What will she get? She gets a yellow bird. I mean, the yellow bird's effective. I'm not complaining or anything, but... Look, he's slowing down.
He only has 2 feet left. Oh, for a second I thought the squid cured itself.
No. Thankfully we don't have to worry about that for a while. Oh, we can cast Chocobo 3 more times.
Choo choo.
Chocobo!
You can only sing that a little much.
That's right, I did all the work. Stupid tentacle monster, I showed you. You don't mess with this little girl.
And we can go to the Demacian from behind this waterfall. It leads to the exit.
I still don't know how normal people travel this path. I mean, I get that the monsters are new, but... To get from one place to the other, you had to go into a cave, climb a halt, climb up really, really high, jump down a waterfall. And now we'll head towards the castle. Look, the castle. Ready to go to the castle? Find her, his daughter.
What the hell? Hey, the bullet chips. Are they gonna get bombed? We're gonna bomb the cat. Oh, there it is. Well, that used to be a town.
Makes you wonder why we flew down and took the crystal.
Oh, you shit, Mr. Cecil! So?
Oh god, my daughter's in here. Blech.
Blech. They took that crystal! Terrible bombardments from the airships.
No, please. You guys were inside. You didn't see shit.
I love that we just don't bother to cure any of them. Look at that.
There's a pot of recovery above. You can heal the citizens. Hey, we're going.
You can take us up there and we'll get better. Wait, come back. Why are you leaving us?
Is that the bard?
Yep.
You're the bard. You did this to her.
Nope. Okay. Crazy old man. Crazy old man. Help!
You swindler.
Please listen for a second. Just calm down.
Old man, kick your ass. Punch you in the face. You spoony bard.
Please, let's calm down. Emma, I think you've got the wrong idea about this whole situation, and maybe if you stop
you
punching
face.
Me... Sir?
Shut up.
Sir, you are clearly in your 80s. You cannot punch me. Please calm down.
You're right, I should lightning bolt your ass. Oh yeah, I decked your face.
Okay, that one actually kind of hurt.
Shut your mouth.
Oh, look, my daughter's alive. Maybe I should pay attention to that.
Okay, the bard looks like he is wearing a freaking one-piece swimsuit, like little chony white undies. Are you alright?
Father, Edward is the Prince of Demacian. He was disguised as a bard when he came to see me in Kaipo. Forgive me for running away, but I love Edward, and we thought of asking for your consent. But when we were about to leave...
Golba has attacked us with Baron's red wings.
Who is that man?
I don't know.
But why?
He took our crystal of fire, and Anna shielded me from the arrows.
Because he has money!
You loved him that much.
Father, forgive me. I love Edward.
It's money!
Anna?
Anna! Anna!
Who is Golbez?
I heard that he was gathering the crystals using the Baron's red wings.
Stop crying. Your tears won't bring her back. Wait for me, Gomez. I'm coming to avenge my daughter.
You can't go alone. God damn it.
The fuck I can't. I don't need any help. This is my own affair.
Wait.
Anna.
I know how it feels. Cecil killed my mother. You cry, baby?
That looks like an angry face.
You are a man. You are a grown-up. You are not the only one who has lost loved ones.
Radia.
You may be right. I'm just a coward. But I don't care. I'm staying here with Anna.
You're not the only one who is sad, Edward. Besides, Anna won't be happy if you do that. We really need your help, so come on, let's go.
My help?
I am Cecil. I'm looking for the Sand Ruby to help my friend who is ill in Kaipo. And I need your help.
I help you?
Yes, you.
I don't know, Cecil. I think he hit his head.
She seems to be an important person. You shouldn't lose your loved one just because I've lost all of mine.
Hey, what about me?
The Sand Ruby is made from the antlion when it lays its eggs in the cave.
That sounds disgusting.
The cave is in the east, though we must go across the shallows to get there. There is a hovercraft the Demisian can use. We can also go to Kaipo through the shallows. Let's hurry. Prince Edward joined his bard.
I've been dreaming of a true love's kiss.
And a missus I've begun to miss. Short and sweet, waiting to complete my...
She's dead.
Goodbye, Anna.
That's creepy.
Witchcraft! Flee the castle!
I'm gonna leave here in my tiny little whitey tidies. Are you taking a hovercraft?
Yeah, we get hovercraft.
Can you go anywhere?
Just where there's rock car.
Uh-uh.
Alright. Let's get him where he needs to be.
His avatar looks very happy.
See if we can get him. No, he's good. Alright, we're going to use up a tent here.
Will Cecil and friends get the Antlion's Ruby? Will there be anything interesting in this cave? Will they get back in time to save Rosa? And who is Golbez?
Dun.
Find out next time when Pixel Kitsune plays Final Fantasy II.